Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you two ways of making multicolor gradient blends that you might not have thought of before. And if you have a moment, please hit the subscribe button to just keep this graphic design content coming. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first we're going to do a gradient blend, and this will take two different gradients and blend them together. So on this side, we're going to have an orange and a pink gradient, and over here we'll have a purple to yellow gradient. So to do that, I'm just going to get on my gradient tool here, and I'll also bring up my gradient panel over here. Now, if you're not seeing the gradient panel, you can come up under window and it'll be under there. First, I'm going to click right here on the gradient to give me a white and black gradient. I'll double click here to set my color. I'll get in my palette and I'm just going to choose, we'll go with this orange. Then I'll click my other color here and I'm going to make this one pink. Okay, and then I'll change it to 90 degrees. So now we have our orange to pink gradient. I'm getting back on my selection tool because I don't actually want a stroke. So I'll bring that to the front and then just get rid of it. Now, since this one is sort of already set up, I'm going to delete this one and just make a copy of this one, holding Shift and Option or Alt and dragging. I'll get back on my gradient tool and then I'll just change this one to purple and this one to yellow. You can also do that right here. Now I'll select both of these and blend them together. So to do that, I'm going to come here to Object, Blend, and Blend Options. I just want this to be smooth color, and it doesn't really matter orientation on this since it's two squares, and I'll say okay. So that doesn't change it, that's just changing your options. And now we have to go to Object, Blend, and Make. Now, as you can see, this is not exactly what we're looking for. So what we need to do is undo with Command Z or Control Z. Sometimes your smooth gradients work, but for me, they seem really inconsistent. So if we want a smooth looking gradient, all we have to do is go to Object, Blend, and Blend Options again. Change this to Specified Steps, and we can make this about 100. And we'll say okay. Then we'll go ahead and go to Object, Blend, and Make. You can also hit Shift-Command-B or Shift-Control-B on a PC. I'm going to move this away from those words and just delete those. And now we have the beautiful gradient that we are expecting. So that's the first way of making the multicolor gradient. The second way you can try is the freeform gradient. And to make this one, you can just make a rectangle. So I'm going to hit M to get to my rectangle tool right over here. And then I'll just draw a box like this. Next, in my gradient panel, I'm going to choose this very last one, which is called Freeform Gradient. And now it automatically starts us out with a gradient. And we have these four nodes. Now, the cool thing about this is we can double click these to change our color. We can move them around so they take up more of the area. And we can even click down here and expand the gradient that way. And I'm going to make this gradient look pretty similar to this one up here. We'll make that orange. I'm going to double click this one, make it yellow. We'll make this a darker purple. And this one looks like it's already the right color of pink. Okay, so now we have two very similar multicolor gradients, but they're just made differently. Now, my favorite thing to do with these is to overlay white text, something like this. I just think that's a really nice effect. Now, because these are made differently, when we expand them, we get two different results. So I'm going to go to Object, Expand Appearance to show you what I mean. And then we'll do Object and Expand. I'll expand the object and fill. And we have the option to change this to a gradient mesh, but I'm going to go ahead and tell it to do 255 objects, and we'll say okay. So normally when you expand a gradient, this is what you get. You get a lot of little pieces. I'm hitting Command Y or Control Y to toggle in and out of outline mode. So you can see the difference here. If we use our group selection tool, all of these are different pieces. And now this one has been changed to something called non-native art. And you can kind of do an internet search, but basically it changes it to kind of an image. And just like all gradients, I feel like, it can cause printing problems, so just be aware of that. So I hope this video was helpful for you. Please let me know if you have any questions or comments. You can leave those in the comment section below. All right, if you like this video, please hit the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.